Excel has a really powerful and convenient feature called functions. A function is a predefined formula, and it's used when a formula would be too complicated or just too long. You can access them from the Formulas tab. There are hundreds of functions that you can choose from, and they're organized by category in the function library. For example, the financial category contains functions that deal with things like interest and monthly payments. The text category allows you to convert text to lowercase or uppercase, replace text, and do other types of text manipulation. Date and time includes functions that return the current date, time, day of the week, and others. And there are many more functions. Much of the time, though, you'll just need to use common functions, such as sum and average, and you can access these by clicking the Auto Sum drop-down arrow. In this example, I'd like to add all of these cells. If I tried to create a formula for this, I would have to add each one individually, and that would get pretty long, and if I had to add hundreds of cells, then it would really not be manageable at all. So I'm just going to add them by using a function. Click on the cell where you want the function to be, and then click on the Auto Sum drop-down arrow and select Sum. Now this has inserted the function, and it's also selected the cells that are being added. If it selects the wrong cells, then we can always change that by dragging these corner handles. But this looks right, so I'll press Enter to get the result. Let's look at this function in a little bit more detail. Just like formulas, functions always start with the equals sign. But you might notice that there are no mathematical operators such as addition or subtraction like you would normally see in a formula. Instead, functions have a specific syntax that includes the name of the function, followed by one or more arguments in parentheses. The arguments tell the function which cells or numbers to use to calculate the result. In this example, we actually only have one argument, even though there are two different cell references. This is called a range of cells. A range of cells is indicated by two cell references separated by a colon. In this case, the range consists of all the cells from F6 to F14. If you want to use more than one argument, you'll need to separate them with commas. Let's try a different function now. In this example, we have a column for the date that each item was ordered and the date that it was received, and I'd like to know how many business days it took to receive the item after it was ordered. First, select the cell where you want the function to go, and if you know which category your function is in, you can select it from there, or you can just search for the function by clicking the Insert Function command. Just type in a description of what you're looking for. I'm looking for a function that can count the number of days elapsed, so I'll type count days and press enter. We've gotten a lot of different results here. You can click on a function and read a description of it below. Net workdays returns the number of workdays between two dates, and that's what we want. So I'll click OK. There will be a field for each argument, and this function has up to three arguments, the start date, end date, and holidays. When you click in each field, you can see a description of it below. And if you need more help on a particular function, you can click Help on this function. I'll select G6 for the start date, H6 for the end date, and the holidays argument is optional, so I'll just leave it blank. You'll be able to see the result here. Click OK, and the function will be added to the worksheet. Just like with formulas, we can drag the fill handle to copy it. And now we can see how long it took each of these items to arrive. If you've never used functions before, the syntax may seem a little strange at first, but with some practice, you'll start to get the hang of it, And over time, you'll probably find your favorite functions that you'll use over and over again.
Like what you just saw? Rate it.
Add a comment.
Subscribe to our channel.
The freedom to learn.
What you want, when you want.
Absolutely free.
GCFLearnFree.org.